So, Zane ist die Expendable AI Network, not IT Network, but okay. So, what we came to realize is that if, yeah, what Henry Ford said those days, that if, yeah, if you want to build something that, and they asked him if they wanted, if he wanted, yeah, faster horses, then this is not what he would have come up with is the car, right? This is not really what he would have done. So this is kind of where we think, or what we try to take as a direction when thinking about a new concept. And we put a lot of thought in really putting also a vision on the, yeah, on the whole new next steps that we are taking, which is that we want to create a world of equally intelligent distributed systems that enable meaningful collaboration and trust. So this is with regards to current centralized systems of power when it comes to data control, AI control, these kind of questions. This is something where we want to be able to have, yeah, equally distributed intelligent systems not focused on one single entity. Just to give you a bit of more context, what we have kind of come to learn. So we realized, okay, that privacy and regulation is becoming more and more important when it comes to specifically blockchain applications, but also to know new business cases, new business propositions. The second part is obviously AI, automation of business processes, more streamlined business processes. How do, does my business stay ahead of the curve within the next couple of years? And yeah, it's the obligation to essentially monitor and audit your data and your, yeah, your internal processes in order to fulfill compliance. See Dieselgate. So, what did we kind of come to realize? Yeah, we worked a lot with different pure blockchain technologies, but also pure AI technologies. But we also drew a lot of new understandings from combining the two, as we have a very interdisciplinary team, and we have a technology that is patented and that we implemented for enterprise that already combines the two, which I will get into more later. But we also came to realize, okay, how do we, if even if we have that blockchain technology that is built with help by AI, but also using other AI concepts, pure AI concepts for automation, and leveraging both sides for each other. So this is essentially where we think there should be an enterprise platform that truly understands how to use both in order to create proper new business models and not just forced new business models. What is our origin? So the core team is a team of cryptographers and engineers that has been working on the Expendable AI Network since 2014 from Oxford. So there they were kind of stress testing different blockchain systems like Corda, Hyperledger, IOTA, and they managed to break most of the systems in production environments. And they came to realize, okay, we need a new mechanism specifically for consensus. This is something I'll talk about more later. Because they, yeah, kind of tried to write mathematical proofs for different consensus algorithms. And they realized, okay, we can also try to use machine learning to kind of make up for the flaws in current systems. So after a couple of years of research, this research project was kind of fully incorporated into a company, commercialized, so to say, which was then called Zane AG and was founded almost a year ago in Berlin. And since then, we have implemented a couple of successful pilot projects. First one was with Mercedes with regards to production facilities. And the second one was the, yeah, winning the Porsche Innovation Contest in June last year and now essentially having the first public pilot that we probably most of you saw in the news recently, where we kind of managed to implement blockchain into cars successfully and making cars a node in the blockchain system. Yeah, this is not working so well. Yeah, so what did we learn from last year? The first of all, I learned it's, yeah, it's not so easy for a business with traditional thinking to define a valid blockchain use case. Specifically talking about private blockchains, if you try to implement a private blockchain for a single business entity, often it's very difficult to convince someone that it makes more sense than a centralized existing system. Once you want to take it a step further into a consortia solution, you quickly realize, okay, this can be done technically, but it's very difficult to be implemented on a policy scale. It's very difficult to put decision makers from different enterprises into a room, first of all, find an appointment, and then second of all, agree on a specific topic. So this, we have experience, can take up to years, 2 years, 3 years, and will take even more years for such systems to be implemented on a larger scale. Additionally, this is what we learned in Oxford, is that many blockchains are not enterprise ready yet. So they're often built even as, they're built as test systems often. This is all they are currently built for. And the third part is that, even though enterprise also realize they might want to use public blockchains because this is when a blockchain really makes sense, they also know, okay, at the moment they are not scalable, they're also highly centralized still, they can be controlled by very few actors that hold most of the stake or most of the control of the network, which is also something that has to be changed with new blockchain technologies. What do we see as our mission for the next couple of years with this knowledge that we gathered? So we believe that we want to help building an interoperable and energy efficient infrastructure in which humans and organizations, but also devices, can interact together. We do not think that a machine economy will be built next year, maybe in 15 years, maybe in 20 years. But to get there, first of all, we need to properly learn how to interact with machines as humans, but also as organizations. And to achieve this, we are now proposing the public enterprise blockchain, which is built on top of the expendable AI network, which is supposed to be used as a plug-and-play open auditing platform, which is kind of relating to what we realize is the most important and most simple use case for blockchain technology is this auditing function that it has. You can time lock and audit data, essentially, or different business cases, which this relates to. So we kind of came up with a new proposition, which essentially is using different services or different layers of the protocol that we built. So at its core, it's the Zane, it's this expendable AI network. I'll explain a little bit why and like what consensus it uses and how it kind of works. On top of it, we think that companies and enterprises should have their own, they should have the capacity to keep control of their data for now. So they should be able to have their internal logics, their internal automation on their own data, but they need to be able to hash their data and put it into a public blockchain in a very efficient manner. So they're doing this, they want to be doing this, but often if you want to put a consortia solution together, then you need to put the stakeholders together. But what if you had a blockchain that could do exactly this without having to think about all the other ugly parts behind it? So if you could simply have a plug-and-play solution. Behind it, only you yourself would be able to encrypt the data or decrypt the data on your on-premise sites through different automation engines. So along our journey, we have built solutions where we have a solution for automated accounting. So basically, once the information is hashed into that blockchain, you want to be able to have an automated way of getting the information back of that data and then reusing it to improve your business processes and your data across the globe, across your manufacturing facilities, but essentially at some point also with your peers or with other companies for specific cross-company use cases. So we believe that the first step will be kind of connecting those enterprises together on one blockchain, doesn't matter which vertical. And the second step will be a public verification of that data or of that hashing power through machines, but also through humans. So through our consensus mechanism, we believe that We can also have a plug-and-play solution on the other side. So basically, a human, a machine, we have proven this with Porsche, can be plugged in as a node to that blockchain. And essentially be a validator node in the consensus race that we propose. So what is it that I'm talking about with this consensus? So essentially the consensus that we have, that we are proposing, that we have built, is based on the realization that the only true randomized consensus is proof of work. So Leif, the founder of Zane, he has basically written mathematical proofs for proof of stake, for BBFT. He has worked with Hyperledger, and he realized, okay, this doesn't scale. POS also doesn't scale, and it still centralizes in many ways. And it might scale, but it's not as secure as proof of work. So the essence of this is, okay, we still want to use proof of work as a core. What we're trying to do, or what we're currently doing with enterprises, is we implement private solutions in which essentially those nodes are whitelisted. We know the nodes, and in the first step, a cryptographic partitioning function out of the Algorand protocol is used to basically form a committee each new time a block is mined randomly. So each node will not know if he's chosen or not in the next race. And then that committee only does the proof of work, which means that if you have, for example, 100 nodes and you have essentially 30 doing the proof of work, then you could scale up those 100 nodes to 200, 300, but you still only need 30 to do the proof of work. The second part that we have built is essentially this SASA engine, which is sitting on top of the nodes. So we have, at the moment, we are using a very strongly modified Geth clients, which are the Ethereum clients, with small Python scripts to enable machine learning along this network. And what we do with it is essentially having the capacity or the possibility to monitor the network. And if nodes go online or offline, for example, with cars, so if you have a car sharing application and you want to drive a car in the night and the cars themselves present the network, then you need to have a mechanism that you can use the same application in the same time, then on the day. So what do? You kind of try to have this AI change parameters in this consensus that you saw before, automatically adjusting the system so that it will basically stay robust and stay secure, the same as it would be with all the cars online, I don't know, at rush hour. So this is kind of achieved by this, it's a reinforcement learning engine that essentially listens to what is happening in the network, and then it can change or upscale the difficulty, it can change the hash rate, it can even, we have even one use case where we managed to add, that it can add nodes automatically or start running nodes. So kind of like a predictive mechanism in the network. So what do we see as the new or as the core benefits and USPs of Zane with that? So we try to build a plug-and-play solution. We have currently built a few integrations to SAP. We want to enable automatic data monitoring and auditing. This can be done through some services that we have built, but we also are in discussions with IBM Watson, for example. They are kind of looking also for something like this to have their services, their machine learning and automation services on top of our system. We integrate with small machines, ECUs and cars, IoT devices of any kind. And we try to do that without having to change too much of the hardware or even nothing, just through a software update. And essentially we are keeping in mind privacy by design mechanisms, which is kind of my specialty. So we build it in a way that the data will not be shared, but purely the keys will be shared through, for example, proxy encryption with NuCypher. This means we have a decentralized, or probably after April, we will have a decentralized key management system that can run on top of Zane as well. And we, through our consensus mechanism, achieve essentially energy efficient scale. We have done this first private solution, which was in the news, which was it was related to Porsche, and it was a very putting blockchain cars onto a blockchain and being able to share permissions to open those cars. So in the old world, instead of those cars at point two, you would have a centralized service. You would send information there, it would send information to the car and it would open the car if you open it with your phone. Now what we managed to achieve is that this information is shared between the cars themselves. And this can also be done only if your phone is online, the car can detect it and can react to it. Essentially, we are also working on other use cases with the same company with regards to predictive maintenance, with regards to different other topics. Also, I guess in the long term, it's often related to autonomous driving. The second implementation was with Mercedes to kind of try to put production machines onto the blockchain and then having the ability to cross-check with different production facilities, basically as input for predictive maintenance models. What is the current core team? So we have kind of restructured our team a little bit during the last weeks. So Leif is the founder. He's former, he studies in Oxford. He's a PhD from Oxford. He worked at IBM, Mercedes, and Daimler, where he got to know Felix and Daimler. And essentially then we have a CFO who used to work for the Bank of Mitsubishi in Tokyo. And Daniel, our CTO, he used to build, he was heading a team of around 100 AI engineers at different automotive but also other companies. And this is Dennis, me as CIO now, and Jesse, who is the marketing manager. Besides that, we have currently around 20 employees, 20 to 25. We're at the moment still completely bootstrapped. And those are our core partners and clients. So the first row, I would say, is kind of like the client list. Second one is more with regards to partnerships. And the third row is basically partners and clients from the blockchain world. So what's next for us? So we are looking forward to kind of keep developing this public enterprise blockchain and plugging in different enterprises to test it. We already have a few commitments to this and a lot of requests towards doing this. And you can drop us a line or meet us essentially here now today for the next 10 minutes, but then probably only through the online channels that we provide. Thank you very much. That's it.
So we have 5 minutes for questions and for feedback on the presentation. So go ahead.
No questions? Too much for everyone to process?
What is your picture for focus regarding doing business? Because you need to make a lot of research at the moment. And all the foundations for companies that are working on the issues at hand, be it scalability or any other, and they're doing mostly research. And then you have developer tools building up slowly. Are you focusing very much on doing research, or are you waiting for others? And then you bring pieces together and have clients and implement it with clients? Because everything at all, for research, it probably needs some more years until we come to production environments, and you cannot run a company. You can, of course, but you need to have a very long view with this.
At the moment, which is basically, we have implemented a lot of private blockchains. We have researched. There was a team in Oxford for 3 years almost researching on this technology, and then also patenting it and proving it with different enterprise clients, different universities that have kind of done the, let's say, scientific verification of most of those parts. I fully agree with you, to implement this, there has to be a lot more work done, but essentially we have proven to ourselves that this works for a private blockchain. So we know that it works in a controlled environment. So we kind of are now planning to step by step opening it up in a, like, let's say, in a clever way, and we will take, I mean, we have a timeline for the public version at least a year, right? We're not being unrealistic about it because we know what it takes to kind of start implementing this for a company. What we already do know is that with this test version, if it's just between enterprises, we can, yeah, have a valid business licensing model very soon. And I think this is kind of where we come from. Like, many, many parts we have already, yeah, tested, and they're already kind of going into the new production phases. But yeah, I mean, do you know any blockchain application that's already working or that has the potential to work? And this is a big question, because there's many out there that essentially, yeah, they're very early stage and they couldn't even work in production, you know? And we think we at least have something that we're pretty sure, because we have verification, that it can work in production, because all the people in our team, they have built their whole life production systems for enterprises, you know? They have worked for automotive, they have worked for banking. One of our core developers have built trading systems for BlackRock and JP Morgan, and they know how to build production systems that have to run in production. So they at least have the know-how of how to bring this into a production system, right? And this is why, yeah, we think this will work, but it will take its fair time, right? And I fully agree with you on that, but I don't think it will going to be many, many years, because at a specific scale, we can already implement it, and we have already shown that it works.